We're live at Newsom Stadium in Nashville, home of the Lycans, where country music started.
A bit of trivia for you, Grim. Nashville has the lowest number of teeth per person.
Whatever. Remember, in the MFL, we encourage you to play with your food. He's probably lining up against you. The Cracksumskull Jugulars battle the Nashville Lycans. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Hello once again, everyone. Grim Blitzrow here, along with Brickhead Mulligan. Hey, how'd your checkup go?
Well, good news, bad news. Doc says I passed my physical.
Oh, that's good.
But I flunked my medal.
Not too good.
Well, it's 50-50. Better odds than I get in Vegas.
Get a point. And it's first and 10. It's 2-yard run before he stopped. And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go. Third down, and the punter is warming up. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he put all of his foot into that one. And he snags the punt and looks for open field. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my offseason.
And it's 1st and 10. Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. Second down and 9. Boom to the moon! Another loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Briggs.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
And it's 1st and 10. He had nowhere to go and got nothing out of it. Second down and 10. Third down and, well, good luck. If you don't think you can make the interception, batting it down is the next best thing.
Great advice, Grim. Receiver's gonna go far in this league if he listens to you.
I wasn't talking to... Yeah, never mind. Yes, Brick, he will. The quarterback has had enough and calls a murder ball dirty trick to lay waste. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. First and 2. Touchdown! first and long. And they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. First down in a mile. It's about a 3-yard pickup. Whoa, mama. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner.
Oh, that was a great throw and a great.
He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. And it's first and ten. Put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? The offense lost another running back and only two remain on their roster. When a team loses all their running backs, they lose their ability to run the ball.
Hey, like that, rip out your tongue, you won't be able to speak. Tell us something we don't know, genius.
Second down and five. For a touchdown. And that's quite a creative and intuitive dance he's doing.
Hey, Grim, what do you call a wolf who was intuitive?
I don't know, what?
And a werewolf. Oh, man, I just cracked myself up.
Well, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. Chokes.
Yeah, he's a choker.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
And it's first and ten. With the brutal hit. Second down and long. Third down and long. And that's the kind of play you pay the secondary for.
You pay him for the pick six. For this, you just give him a pat on the head and tell him they don't suck.
Now, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Oh, nice hit.
Bingo! Bingo! I just hit that mutant bingo! And all I was missing was his number for the last three plays. Talk about luck!
And it's first and ten. Talk about Butterfingers. He should have had that one. Second down and ten. Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
The offense is down to their last running back. If they lose him, They lose all their running plays. And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot. And he picks up about 6 on the play. Third down and 6. And that's a run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
That's the end of the first quarter, and it's still anyone's game. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. The cross-stitching, unbelievable.
He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. Oh, with the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10. Crushed. And it's first and 10.
You know, this berserk dirty trick ain't standing in a QB. It's like inviting.
And that's how you run the football. A pickup of 7 on the play.
Stand clowns don't play football. They'd be good.
You know, they're all in politics, apparently. Oh, man, Bricks, you gotta love a player who goes down fighting. First and 10. The defender blows up the receiver on the play and knocks the ball loose. Second down and 10. Warming up. Man, this guy just blew up and he's on fire. I'm not talking about one of those video game fire modes. I mean, literally, he's now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Bam! Oh, man, that's the end of his day. He might want to try hurling those traps next time. First and 10. And he just used his beast boost dirty trick, and there's no way to stop him. Unless, of course, you kill him.
Wow, look at that freak go. He's unstoppable.
And he finds open space. He's running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
It's first and 10. Tired of the quarterback tight spirals. And if this guy could talk before he died, what do you think he'd be saying, Bricks?
Psycho killer! Just to say, what the fuck?
And it's first and 10. At this rate, the QB's gonna have...
Oh, man, he really wants it!
And he's off to the races! They might catch him!
Move, you fat little mutant!
He's hit the... He could go all the... Yeah, never mind. And it's first and 10. Picks up 2 yards on the pass.
And this guy's 6 feet tall. He could just have fallen over and gotten 2 yards.
And that'll be second and 8 to go. And he reels that one in for a first. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
And it's first and 10. That ball just sliced through the defense like butter.
I wish defense...
He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Chokes.
Yeah, he's a choker. He's a midnight smoker.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. The ref calls a penalty. You know, the MFL has eliminated almost every penalty in the rule book, and yet it still feels like there's way too many penalties.
Stupid jerks. You guys suck.
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
You know, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They had the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and 10. And he was stuck to him like glue. Second down and 10. Ouch! That's gotta hurt. Man, those mutant traps will kill you faster than one of Brick's farts. Comes the extra point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. And that has a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, no, Briggs. It means he can return it for... You know what? He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now.
A man from prison just came out of the field.
It's the ref, idiot.
Oh.
Let's see what the penalty is. The burn returner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. First and four. Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
Second and three. Oh, with a punishing hit, the quarterback goes down. Third down and six. And another interception. Man, what a hit that was. The coach isn't liking that call. Oh, his head just exploded.
Let him miss. Oh, shit.
Third and two. The defense had enough with this rep and jumps off sides to kill him. And that'll bring up third down and inches. And he zips that one in there for a touchdown. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and ten.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents.
And they quickly call a timeout to stop the clock. And that'll be second down and four. Oh, the unstoppable force meets the explodable object. And the defense scrummed it out and came up with the ball. Punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked. The offense lost their final running back. Lucky for them, they're on defense now.
They're lucky to survive so much bad luck, carnage, and death for him.
And it's first and ten. And the back gets in there and swats the ball away.
He can't catch, but he sure can.
And the offense goes into a hurry up to pick up the pace of the game. And that mutant just about met his maker on that hit.
I thought he was made in China.
I don't see any Chinese guys down there.
You're a fucking moron.
Smart move there, stopping the clock with their first timeout.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense, quick pass, picks up maybe 2 yards. Second and 3. They stop the clock, but they only have 1 timeout left.
That's okay, Grim. They can have 9.
That's nice, Bricks. But our timeouts are for our sponsors, and we need money more than they do. And there's another pick. Boom! And it's 1st and 10. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And it's 1st and 10. So this becomes a passing-only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Grim?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron.
Hey, watch it!
And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go. Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. Nicely done for a 1st down. And that's the end of the 2nd quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. We're back for the 2nd half as the teams line up for the kickoff. The coach told his players they'll be strung up on the goalposts if they don't make this a game in the 2nd half.
That's how you motivate these pricks.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. And it's 1st and 10. Oh, man, the offense called a murder ball.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
It's 1st and 10. Does the QB know which team he's on?
I don't even know.
And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run. Oh, holy smokes. He just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the MFL. And it's 1st and 10. And the defense goes for the jugular and rushes to kill the quarterback. And the quarterback says, I don't think so, and runs out of bounds, leaving the defense in the dust. Nice try, fellas, but no cigar. First and goal. He had it for a 2nd there. And it's 1st and 10. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. It's first and ten. And that's another turnover for the defense. And he just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? He's at the 30. The 20. Oh, look at this guy break. Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
He's at the 40. And he runs out of gas and got tackled short of the goal line. Hell of a run, though. First and ten. And with another pick, the QB says, I don't know him. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
No, still working on my salami here, Bricks. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. And it's first and ten. And he stayed with the receiver and deflected the ball. Second down and ten. Mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Yep. Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. Probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and ten. Oh, and that's how you play defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick. Second down and ten. He just knocked him into the next time zone.
There's a bloody red head on the field.
No, that's their red penalty marker, Briggs. Looks like this one's coming back. The offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and have only two left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, Grim, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore. Other than the funeral expenses, that is.
And it's first and ten. And like a monkey gets the ball, get the first down and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and ten. The defense better watch out. The quarterback just threw a murder ball. He broke free and has open field. Why go for one when you could go for two?
It's always been my philosophy, but Bricks can't even get one. Oh, you're talking about points.
No one was going to stop him. That's 2 points. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed, it was a chip wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. Nice pickup for 6 yards. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
And that'll be 2nd down and 4. The quarterback goes down. Zoom on his face. I want to see if he's crying. Third down and, well, good luck. And the quarterback throws another pick. He should have eaten his sleep. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math. It looks like we've got a penalty here. The defense is running low on linebackers. They have only 2 left. They need to play smart from here on out.
It's defense, Grim. You're asking too much of them.
And it's 1st and 10. And that's a run for no gain. Second down and 10. No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. And it's 1st and 10. Come on, that was a cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. And so do the fans. And it's 1st and 10. Oh, and they just deflated the quarterback's balls right there. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. And the defense gets it, and he bursts into the end zone for the score. What a run! If you think his dancing is bad, you should have been here in the old days. They used to mark their territory the old-fashioned way. But they agreed to dial it down to interpretive dance.
I took an interpretive dance class with a werewolf once, Grim. He damn near clawed my face off.
That was before the class even started.
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
Damn, this guy couldn't hit the side of a fallout shelter. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
It's 1st and 10. teammates are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. The 30. He's at the 20. Oh, the unstoppable force meets the explodable object. And lifesaver there. And it's first and 10. Ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? That line ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks. Second down and 10. And he stayed with the receiver and deflected the ball. Third down and 10. Another loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
Now, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. And he's got a chance for a good return here. Great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
The third quarter mercifully ends. If this game is as painful to watch as we are to listen to, then please accept our apologies. This one is just about over. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a two-minute drill. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about the defense is down to their last linebacker. He's going to have to suck it up and not die out there.
They can bribe the refs in this game. Why not bribe the Grim Reaper?
And it's first and 10. That's a killer. It was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league.
And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. Tell he's a berserker because he's frothing at the mouth.
Oh,
I'm running out of excuses for this QB. You just boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger.
The Lycans obliterate the opposition and win by forfeit.
Victory snatched from the jaws of forfeit. Get it, Grim?
Not so much, partner. Not so much. There's not much left of the opposition, and the fans are loving it. There was only one way this game was going to end, and that was in a forfeit.
That's not quite true, Grim. An alien spacecraft could have crashed into the stadium and ended the game. How about if
you shut the hell up right now? We go down to the field and listen.